Hello everybody, my name is Markiplier and welcome back to Firewatch. When we last left off, we're still trying to hunt the source of the problem on the telephone poles, but also I noticed that there was a note here that I didn't see before, so let me read this. Dave, heyo, I got your note about needing to talk. Sorry I didn't track you down. Been looking for you all day, figured you'd be out near the canyon helping the grad students, but I guess not. I don't even know how it could really help anyway. We're coworkers, you know? Amigos, profesionales. If you need someone to throw back a case with and go time traveling, Ron's your guy. But I'm not great with the life stuff. You get it? No, I do not.
Let's see. Who are these guys, Ron and Dave? They're leaving notes for each other in the boxes. Is there any chance one of them was that guy I saw in the canyon? You know, the guy with the flashlight?
No, they're both rangers. They're not out here this season. I didn't really know them that well, but I always assumed the only thing Ron cared about was chasing tail and getting loaded.
Uh-huh.
It's somehow comforting to know that he was able to keep up a correspondence with someone who wasn't going to send him a topless Polaroid.
Oh, okay. I forgot that this is the 80s and that's how nudes were sent, with Polaroids. Okay, so there's a turtle here!
Whoa, I found a turtle.
Maybe it's a tortoise.
Tortoise? It's a thing with a shell.
Well, isn't that something?
Yeah.
It's actually pretty cute.
Well, aww. Henry, if you decide you want to keep you company, nobody will mind.
Oh!
What do I call it? Looks like a,
Turt Reynolds, Shelley Duvall,
may. That'd be good.
Oh, Turt Reynolds. Reynolds! Oh, Turt Reynolds!
Well, now I can't wait to see him.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
the
I'm going to.
Mustache is impressive.
Ooh. You tell him I love Cannonball Run.
It's kind of clipping through my hand a little bit, and he seems to be jerking around uncontrollably, but that's okay. I'm gonna adopt him. Oh, he's my little Turt Reynolds buddy. Oh my god, Turt Reynolds is with me. And I hope that Delilah has forgiven me for my transgressions. I really did feel bad about that yesterday when I was playing this. Like, I was like, oh man, did I ruin everything? Have I made everyone at home sad for what I've done? And I don't know if it actually had a profound effect on anything, but I can assume that I'm not supposed to be here. Never mind, I'm going back. So, I forget, I had something actually important to say about this game. Oh yeah, there was, I'm currently prepping for a trip to Boston to visit a friend of mine, and I said that I was gonna do hour-long episodes, and I fully intend to do that, but at the same time, today, Danny is coming over, and then later today, we're gonna be recording Prop Hunt and maybe some other games, so I'm going to be just a little busy today, so I'm gonna try to do 45-minute episodes for, like, two episodes, and then once I come back from my trip on Monday, then everything should be back to normal. But just wanted to let you guys know that's why the video is a little shorter. I didn't intend to break my promise just yet, but this is just a minor transgression on my long list of grievances. Of all the terrible things that I've done, this probably does not weigh too heavy on my soul. Okay, but anyway, we need to find... Oh yeah, that's right, there was a block over here that I could probably go by. But I'm glad I found that turtle! Man, if I would've overlooked little Turt Reynolds over there, it would've been terrible. Okay.
Guess what?
What is it?
There's a bunch of empty cans up here.
Same as before?
Yep.
These fucking kids.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's quite literal, huh? Let's see.
How could these girls be so stupid?
Trust me, I never underestimate the stupidity of a drunk teenager. Also, I never underestimate the balls of a drunk young woman, having been one.
Oh, okay. Good to know.
Well, I hopped down a drop and now I can't climb back up.
That is a pickle.
Mm-hmm.
I can just keep hiking, but I figured I should let you know in case I get myself trapped out here.
How adventurous of you.
Uh-huh.
I've been doing a lot more climbing out here than I expected.
Well, keep your radio charged. I'd hate to one day find a skeleton with an orange backpack at the bottom of a ravine.
Oh, so you've been spying on me! Me and Turt Reynolds out in the woods all alone! You've been saying- oh, hello. You've been seeing me.
So we really
also,
can't reach anyone any other way than these wires?
What else do you suggest? Smoke signals?
Just seems dangerous.
Well, if they don't hear from me for a few days, they'll send someone out, but I'd rather it not come to that.
Damn it, more beer cans. These goddamn sexy teenagers, who are of legal age, let me be very clear about that. Probably, definitely. I should shut up. Hank over here, or Henry, isn't too happy about anything. Boy, I hope Bernie is safe back- wow, that is a long way away. Did I really walk all that distance? That's incredible! This place is huge, that's awesome! Okay, so anyway. I'm only under the assumption that I'm supposed to go up this way because the beer cans were leading me up here. There might have been something over there if I check the map. No, maybe not. Okay. I'm just gonna continue up here, and maybe on my way back I'll try to hit that area. Because there seems to be a lot of unexplored territory over here and things that I could see that are hidden around. God damn it! Beer cans everywhere! Turd Reynolds wouldn't have any of this! This is abhorrent! This is terrible! What the hell is that shadow over there? Probably a tree, hopefully. Go to hell. Oh. What?
Hey, so the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it.
That's actually good to hear. I can send someone out to fix it. Good find.
Uh-huh. Yeah, the thing is, it doesn't look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately.
Uh-oh.
I knew it. The moment you said you found their trash. These idiots are gonna pay. Do they realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on? And God forbid there's an actual fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
I want you to go find them.
And then what?
I haven't thought that far ahead. That's not true. Everything that comes to mind is illegal.
Let's hear it.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Yeah, I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know. Wait for them to wander off and wreck their camp. Something that would make a teenage girl run home to mommy and daddy.
I'll find them.
Thanks.
But I am gonna need a raise.
Don't hold your breath.
Oh, come
I'd
on!
Start by hiking back towards your tower and just keep an eye out for anything that would lead you to them.
What about this underwear?
Oh, they're big into Red Eagle.
Great. See if you can find the path they took down from there. Maybe they looped back around towards the lake or something. I doubt they're where they were yesterday, but they obviously can't have gone far.
Yeah. I mean, how did they even know who I was? This is obviously a park ranger. They didn't exactly see me. And also, that looks like Bernie. Bernie who's guarding back host at the post. And also, are they running around naked still? Are these just nudist kids that are just trying to run around and ruin everyone's day? Nudist of a perfectly legal age, by the way. Also, how did they get up high enough to cut it that far into the wire? Because if this wire was strung up, they would have had to cut it right about here. And that doesn't make any sense at all. Oh well. There was another side down to the mountain where I see more beer cans over there. So let's just meander our way and clean up their frickin' mess. These gosh darn kids. Did they poop on that rock? Oh god, they messed up poop rock. Alright, I don't need to drop down over there. Oh man, they are just litter bugs. Like how, like these, if these are just these girls drinking all these beers, they are chugging non-stop, borderline death by alcohol here. This is not healthy. So, and I'm assuming they're of legal age to drink, so. Well, they wouldn't be if they're teenagers. This doesn't add up! Something ain't right over here! I don't like the sound of this. Something spoopy's happened. I wonder where I'm stuffing all these cans. I guess I'm gonna recycle them for a fee later on. Is Turt Reynolds still with me? My little buddy? Okay, there's a path back over there. That probably, if the compass is correct, yeah, that leads south. So there's gotta be something up this way, but it's kind of uncharted territory, but there is a supply drop. Maybe I could stop by Delilah and apologize for being intrusive on her conversation. Alright, whatever. Probably not. I probably screwed everything up. My only friend out here to escape the horrible life I have back home. Oh man, if I long drop here, I'm not gonna be able to get back. Alright, balls out! We came here for adventure! I probably should have reported this. Hang on, where was it? Hey, what? I just saw! There was a looky-loo! Oh, god damn it. Okay, so there's Thoroughfare Fire Lookout 4-5 miles that way, and a supply drop, so let me go that way first. I can always loop back and head back another way. Which I'm assuming that it's what it's supposed to do, because the cans kind of led me over here. Ugh. Man. What would it be? Oh my god, it's beautiful! It's beautiful! Man, I just wish that I could come out here. I mean, like I said, I'm not one for camping, but I am one for appreciating the grandeur. The grandeur! Squint! Squint your eyes at the grandeur! I'm one for appreciating the grandeur of just nature. And going out and seeing it. Because I've lived in cities now for too long, and all I know is, like, just constant non-stop. But I did take a trip recently. Oh, hello. Is this one same combination? This one moves slower. Yep, same combination. Man, if someone had short-term memory loss and they forgot that. Oh, god. There's nothing in here! Well, there's nothing in here! This is bullshit! I was promised supplies! I'm not even gonna report to Delilah that the loss of supplies and the supply drop. Maybe there's just nothing there. Anyway, I did take a trip recently to the Grand Canyon, which was frickin' amazing. Because, you know, you hear a lot of stories about the Grand Canyon, and everyone says it's breathtaking and, like, life-changing. Just seeing it in person is astonishing. And I thought it was all exaggeration right up until the point where I actually went there and stood on the edge of the ravine. It was horrifying. Like, it was terrifying. I'm not afraid of heights, but everyone would be afraid of dropping into that, sumbitch. It's just, it's so big. Like, when you're standing on the edge of it, if you look right and look left, all you see in the entire field of view is just the canyon. Like, nothing but the canyon. And that's, like, astonishing on so many levels. It's huge, enormous, beyond big. I would recommend that everyone go see it, because it's such an easy thing to do. And it's an example of, like, the good thing about keeping parks in maintained condition and making sure that they're pristine and not commercialized.
Hey, I'm out at a ravine. What's this thing that spans across it?
That is how you get to my sector.
I don't want to be in my sector.
No kidding. Well, let me hike over.
Well, it's locked up and mainly for emergencies. I've never actually used it. Rangers use it from time to time, but that's it.
Help! Oh, God, it's an emergency!
Oh!
Oh, really?
My leg!
Yeah, I got eyes on a tornado. I gotta get out of here.
A tornado in the heart of the Rockies?
Yes!
Holy moly, I need to call this in. Tom, Two Forks sees a tornado. He says he needs an evac into my sector. It's a meteorological impossibility. There haven't been tornadoes in the greater Yellowstone region in 100 million years. You're gonna need him to stay and take a detailed personal account, even if it means giving his life. Okay, I'll tell him. Sorry, Hank. No dice.
Man.
I detect some sass. I'll have you know I'm a professional Victoria's Secret model, and Turt Reynolds needs some food or something. And all the female turtles are over there. I mean, tortoises. Oh, God! I'm going out of my mind! Okay, let's just continue on. It was with our little adventure here. With Turt Reynolds by our side. Yeah! It's weird! I'm Tiny Tortoise Tim! It's sadly, you know, analogous to everything that you've done before! Oh, thank you, Tiny Tortoise Tim! You know, you'll always be my little biscuit! Oh, that sounds familiar! I wonder where you came up with that one! Oh, you know, places and things. Oh, sounds like you're making excuses and trying to buy time because your brain can't keep up with the shit that your ass is cashing for you! What the hell did you say, Tiny Turtle Tortoise Tim? I don't know. Maybe we're one voice, two voices in the same head. Oh, look, a backpack. You can stop this monologue now.
There's an abandoned pack out here.
And it's not one of the teens?
No, it looks like it was lost a long time ago.
Well, you could always pilfer it for supplies.
Okay. Is that legal? Swipe. I'm a cat batting it off of the tree. Brian Goodwin. Ah, God, my face. Okay, I got a camera, and I got rope.
Well, I am flush with ropes now.
Uh-huh.
That pack was full of them, in decent condition, too.
Great.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this. This pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
Ooh.
With pictures left?
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
Thank you, Brian Goodwin.
Uh-huh. I wonder what's on the first dude.
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top.
Huh. Wow.
Do you know him?
Yeah, I just haven't heard that name in a few years.
Was he a ranger or something?
Oh, no. He was stationed in Two Forks, your lookout, with his dad Ned 3 summers ago. Great kid.
You can bring children out here?
No. You know, I'm not a stickler for rules. They took off halfway through the summer.
Whoa.
You guys keep in touch, you and the Goodwin kid?
Nah, they took off pretty unceremoniously. Plus, what's a 40-year-old woman gonna do with a teenage pen pal?
Good point.
Anyway, so it goes. Mm-hmm. Have fun with that camera.
I sure will.
Anything that would scar a photodome employee?
I don't know, I got a lot of hiking to do. Might get bored.
Uh-huh.
Well, I'm bored as rocks, so I'll keep you company while you find those girls, huh?
Okay, looks like Delilah's finally forgiven me, so all is well in the world. And I got a disposable camera. I'm assuming that I can only take so many pictures with it, and I should probably save that for a good occasion instead of snapping photography of the scene, or a scenery photography. Whoa!
I see a really thin plume of smoke.
Yeah, I see it too. A thin plume like this is either a new fire or a campfire.
Campfire? You think it's them?
I reckon so.
It looks like it's to the southwest of me.
That's right. If you hike towards 5 Mile Creek, that should put you in the neighborhood.
Uh-huh.
Keep an eye on that smoke plume. Let me know if it's getting any larger.
Okay. Will do. Okay. Guess who's going out with Debbie next week? No, not that shitheel Steve. It's your main man, Ron! I went up to check on the new guy at Two Forks and heard him talking to himself, more than usual for LOs. So I figured I'd stay away. Remember when you saw the Chimney Rock having himself in that hammock? Oh. Ugh. I'm starting to think the Forest Service only picks the deranged and perverted. Yeah, you would know, Ron. Except for us, of course, because I can't. God damn it, I gotta go to this one. Except for us, of course, work at the creme de la creme. Let's toast to Deb at the spot. Okay, thanks, Ron. You frickin' horn dog. Whoa.
Someone found a fossil and put it in a cash box.
Could be the same person who left that antler.
Huh. Maybe they're leaving me an entire creature, piece by piece.
I should just throw it on the ground and not care about anything. Loose stone. Well, this is very not interesting. I'm glad I picked that up. Okay, and then that's all for that. All right. I'm on the way. I gotta find these girls because apparently they're in danger to everyone and themselves. I wonder if, like, the time is passing normally or if I'm just, like, taking forever to do things.
Hey, sorry about snapping at you earlier. I thought about it and, yeah, I suppose that must have sounded kind of weird when you heard me take that other call. Plus, you're just out here in your own head. Trust me, I know how it is. So, did you break any hearts back in Colorado when you took this job?
Uh-oh. Right to the heart of the matter.
I myself have chosen to never get attached to anyone who would miss me, but I know I'm a bit of an outlier. I don't mean that the way it sounds. I mean, I care about people, and I like companionship as much as the next person. But why does it have to come from the same person for your whole life? My Aunt Kathy was married to the same guy for 4 decades, and when he died, she found out he'd been having an affair with a real estate broker. For 15 years. Goodness. Whereas my Aunt Judy traveled the world dating artists and musicians as she saw fit. Call me crazy, but I'd rather spend a week in bed with Sonny Bono than half a lifetime with some cheating stockbroker.
Sonny Bono.
I'm actually married.
But you're here.
Yeah, it's a long story.
She's sick, and I shouldn't be here, but I am.
I'm sorry, Henry. What is it?
We'll get into it.
Okay.
Yeah, over time.
Well, in the meantime, you are here, and it's beautiful, and escaping isn't always something bad.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure.
Look, I gotta go do a thing, but I'll have a radio. Okay, call me if you need to.
Okay. Thanks, Delilah. Everything's A-okay! Oh, God, I thought everything was ruined.
Hey, Delilah?
Uh-huh.
What do you got? You found him?
No, not yet. Why would there be a fence out here?
Mm-hmm. Because sometimes hikers go ass over tea kettle when on a trail.
So the Forest Service would put up a big chain-link fence?
A chain-link fence?
Yeah. It looks like it surrounds a huge area.
Huh. That's weird.
Yeah. A little weird. Let's see.
Do you think those girls could be behind this fence?
Well, having once been an ornery young woman, the last thing I would do is climb a fence. Especially if I knew I was in trouble.
Who are they keeping out of here? And why?
Yeah, good question.
Jeez, I don't know. Maybe it's biologists, you know? Well, they don't want people traipsing on their precious lichens.
That seems a lot less
What's
likely.
What's a lichen?
It's a mossy
Wouldn't
growth.
You lichen to know?
Wait, isn't a lichen
oh my God,
a mossy
goodbye.
Growth?
I'll ask next time I talk to someone, but that'll probably be a few days.
Okay, no one knows what a lichen is. I could have sworn it was like some type of moss. I'm not 100% sure on that one. It's been a long time since I studied lichen tree. In my lichenology class at Institute of Lichentry. And that's all I have to say about it. I got nothing left. Oh, crap. So this is where the fire took place before. Oh, God. I mean, it's good because fires actually are very natural and they occur, you know, when they're not caused by humans, they occur naturally in forests all the time. They just, like, erupt in flame. But when the trees all burn down, it leaves a lot of room and new, fresh soil to grow. So plants just like sprout up out of fired places. So it's pretty cool. All right, so that supply drop, where am I on the map? Oh God, I'm blazing a new trail here. Okay. All right then, so if I continue down that way, oh, I can't go that way because that's where the fence is. But I can go up the back way of the fence, and then there's probably something being sectioned off either in Wapiti Meadow or Thoroughfare Basin. Okay, only one way to go from now. Me and Turt Reynolds are gonna get out of here.
Oh boy, have you thought of more things for me to say?
No, Tiny Tortoise Tim. I really didn't think out what I would say for two different people, let alone just for myself.
Oh, sounds like you're in quite a pickle. You don't know how to entertain yourself for a few minutes at all.
And I'm like, and I'm like,
all the time getting this
never
fucking
mind.
Flapjack off his ass and out to repair that wire.
Okay. That's interesting.
Oh, man.
What? Do you like that? This guy is the freaking king of the flapjacks.
Yeah, that's solid. I'll have to keep that one in my pocket.
It's all yours.
Oh, thanks, Delilah. I'll keep all these flapjacks in my pockets. All right, there's got to be something out over here because it seems like a big open area where I could easily get... I could easily miss something that's off the beaten path over here. I mean, this is one of those types of games that I want to take very slowly, but at the same time, I know that I got to get through the story, you know, at a relatively good clip for you guys, but I know for a fact that there's got to be some things out here that I'm not entirely seeing. Oh, well, what's the problem with just going over that way? When I was climbing through the woods as a child, I was balls out, jumping up inches at a time over rocks and stones and steps and mountains. Huh?
Oh. She's got Alzheimer's.
Oh, no,
like,
sad.
Dementia.
Whoa. How old was she?
Is she? She's alive. She's with her family in Melbourne, Australia. She's 43.
Fuck.
Yeah.
What was it like when you guys found out?
Probably devastating.
Devastating? Especially for her. You can understand.
And for you.
Anyway, everything she worked for was taken away, and that was it. Yeah. I'm sorry to be such a downer.
Don't even. I'm happy to listen. And, you know, we'll try to have some fun this summer. I promise.
Hmm. I'm guessing that green eye must mean that this is a place that could be taken a picture of. And that is really pretty, so I'll give that a gander. See if my composition is up to snuff. And I'm a photographer. I did it. Okay, that's one I'll take. And that's what I'm assuming it's supposed to be done. But I only have a limited number of things, and I only got one game to play this through. I'm not pulling an Until Dawn and playing through it all again in case I mess something up. Is that important for me? Am I supposed to be worried about that? Because whenever dramatic music starts to kick up, I usually think that something's going horribly wrong for me. Alrighty then. I gotta admit, like, the sound of this game is very interesting. Just the musical score connected with the actual environment of the, you know, the woods and the wooded areas around it. Because there's a lot of subtle ambiance to it that I don't want to get too up my own ass about. But the music combined with everything, and right now when this music kicked up, it kind of reminded me, did everyone remember that scene in Red Dead Redemption, for those of you who played it, when you first cross the border into Mexico, and you just see, like, the epic, long landscapes, and you're riding your horse, and that song kicks up? That's what that reminded me of this just right now, because it's, like, gorgeous, beautiful, breathtaking scenery, all done in a very stylized way, which is, like, unique and interesting. And even though, like, I can see in the background, those are just flat painted things, and you know, it's all just background texture. But seriously, because the art style is so uniform, like everything matches, and that's just good art direction right there. When everything is like stylized in the same way, because there can be it's easy to make inconsistencies in a game, especially when you have a unique style like this. Team Fortress is actually a good example, and a lot of people pointed out in the first episode comments that it kind of reminded them of Team Fortress, and that's because it's simple styling, but uniform throughout, and that's what makes it good. Okay. Oh, wait, I'm back where I was. This is the supply cache. Oh.
People just stuff these things with old food? That's how you get bears.
Those boxes are bear-proof. I wouldn't worry about it.
I don't know about bear proof.
Hey, there's a snack in here. I'm probably gonna eat it.
You definitely do not want to do that. Whatever's in there has been in there for years. That's how you get food poisoning.
No! I really want to eat it now! It says fine right on the bar! Cherry and almond! Alright, fine, I'll drop it. Even though I've probably eaten one already. I won't get food poisoning. That would put me out of commission and probably change the outcome of the game. Blah, blah, blah. I need to be a responsible adult. Rested assured in my own abilities as a human. And I'll go meandering my way. Where's that plume of smoke? Ah, there it is. I mean, if I'm not mistaken, I'm getting closer and closer to the lake, so... Oh, no, I am mistaken. What is the medicine wheel? What the hell is that? I'm actually pretty close to my lookout. I didn't even know that. So I gotta go back down towards the lake, then. There's no other way around it. Alright, let's pick up the pace here. I've been kind of meandering too much, and I'm kind of back to where I was before, so...
So, how'd you meet?
Met in a bar.
The birthplace of modern romance.
I stumbled over and told her she was pretty, and that was it.
No, she said you needed a cheeseburger.
I was drunk.
Yeah. Yeah, she said someone needed to feed you a cheeseburger, and that's gorgeous. This view. Is this view worth taking a picture of? I hope that worked. Okay, good enough. I'm gonna discover when I develop this that the first four pictures are brutal murders, and I'm gonna be incriminated, and everyone's gonna arrest me, and it's gonna be just plain horrible. Whoever Brian Westwood was, he was a horrible person. Also, like, I don't even think I mentioned it. I did a mental note of it, but I didn't mention it. Before, the ropes at the top were, like, broken and flaying in the wind. That kind of suggests that someone did not have a good time, and someone might have died. Sail slide is sleep. Steep sleep is sail slide is steep. The stale side is sleep. Okay, anyway. Back down. This is what happens when you do longer Let's Plays. Your tongue gets tied and your brain farts out your own ass. Alright, making my way downtown. Walking fast, not gonna fall. Gonna break my ass. Anybody around here? Hello? Okay, that was a long one. At least I can get back up from it. I'm gonna be in great shape by the end of this. I mean, not to toot my own horn or anything, but when I saw myself in the Victoria's Secret catalog of 1989, I would say that I looked pretty damn good. Pretty damn good indeed. Okay. Getting closer to it. I mean, that's gotta be a campfire, right? I'm gonna sneak up behind these kids. Ugh, God, that sounds so weird when I do that. I'm not gonna do that anymore. That's Bernie's voice anyway. I gotta make sure that Bernie stays consistent. Terrifying Bernie as he is. Alright. But God damn it, how am I supposed to get over there? I mean, the only way that I... Oh, I know! Ah. Oh, crap. So then I gotta go around the back end of my lookout. No, I'm not going the wrong way. There's gotta be another rope tie off over here. Man, this is a puzzle. So where I am in relation to everything else... Yeah. Okay. So the only way to go about it is go down here. There seems to be another rope tie-off, which means that there's gotta be another drop-off over here. If I'm not mistaken, I'm gonna be wandering around in circles for a while. But if I am lost, I'll just pause it and come back to it later when I find my own way. But I have a funny feeling that I'm right. Rope hook. Rope hook. Rope hook. I was right! Okay, so there's gotta... yeah, that's gonna be it. That's definitely gonna be it. So down this drop-off over here, on this lovely, unmaintained trail... God, what a job this would be. If they had internet out in the woods like this, as terrifying as it would be to be alone in the woods and have the possibility of people breaking in on you, even though Bernie is gonna be watching, you know, but also Bernie is gonna be watching you in the middle of the night, staring at you from the darkness.
What are you gonna do when the fire season wraps up? Are you gonna go be with her? Just go back to Boulder? You should go be with her.
Yeah.
That's my opinion.
Thanks for your
opinion.
Sorry
for the umpteenth time. Anyway, call me when you find the girls. Or anything. Or call me whenever you want.
Well, if I wasn't a married man, I'll probably go.
Maybe I'll go visit. I don't know.
Well, why not?
She's with her family in Melbourne. They're not big fans of mine.
Oh.
Her sister, Susan, is great, but her parents, I think they always thought she could do better. And that I could have done a better job looking after her.
Fuck that. I have no doubt you did your best.
I don't know.
If you want to go visit her, you should go. Don't let a couple of assholes keep you away from someone you love.
I'll think about it.
Uh-huh. Oh, man, that's the question, though. Someone you love, that's kind of hitting a spot. You don't know if Henry still loves her is all. I mean, you know, it's easy to say, you know, that's why there's so many divorces. But I'm not going to get into much of that. But when you go through that kind of crisis and everything, and you have to deal with that, and a person that you love changes completely because of horrible debilitating diseases, like, it's just human to say that's hard. And I don't know what I'd do because I've never been faced with that situation. I'd like to think that I would be noble and, like, no matter what, through thick and thin, always maintain the same feelings. But you never know until you face it. You never know until you reach that point. It's hard to say. Anybody knows.
Huh. How many hikers go missing in the Shoshone?
Mitch Michaels.
More than none, unfortunately, with most of them being in this area. Mm-hmm. The thoroughfare, because it's so remote. Why?
I found an old flyer for a missing hiker. It just got me thinking, that's all. Like how you said one day you were talking to the Goodwins, and then the next you weren't.
Ned Goodwin didn't get mauled by a bear or stuck in a ravine. He was just a PTSD'd a-hole who dragged his son out to do a job and realized it was a bad idea.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
PTSD? That doesn't sound good.
Yeah, I don't know. He was in the army. He was off. It's actually the saddest story. He was only discharged because his mother, Brian's grandmother, died. She'd been taking care of him, and Ned was the only next of kin.
Damn. And you got to know Brian a little bit?
Yeah. I talked to him way more than I'd talked to Ned, that's for sure.
How was he at, you know, spotting fires?
Better than you. He actually liked to stay in the tower.
Hey, it's my second day! Give me a little slack! I'm in the lush woods!
Boy, for as dry as it is, there's some of this area down here that's, lush.
Lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
The lush.
Yeah, I think that's where I am.
That's where I lush.
Those trees are actually one root organism. Did you know that?
What? Whoa!
I didn't know that.
Yeah, they share their water as a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even through fire. Can you believe you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things? Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
Oh, Turt, this is where we find out if you're a tortoise or a turtle. Go swim! But Mark, I'm a tortoise and I swim! Oh, God. No, poor Turt Reynolds. I used to play this song all the time on my live streams. It was Turtle, Turtle. It was by, oh man, he does a lot of remixes. He made the original, like, nom 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 nom. Okay, anyway. That's what I get for singing. But I used to play it on my live streams all the time. Speaking of live streams, there's gonna be one on February, next Saturday, the Saturday after this one, which I believe is either, yeah, the 20th. February 20th is the next charity live stream. I'll be taking suggestions for what I should be playing and what I should be doing at any old time. Oh, wait, I see that. Oh, the music is so pretty. Oh, God, the music is so pretty. Oh, look, it's so pretty. Oh, God, it's so pretty. I can only squint my eyes at the grandeur. I don't see the smoke anymore, which either means that they left and I wasn't quick enough. I don't even know if I'm on a time trial here, because I think that... Man, it's either that the day progresses slowly, or just that it progresses as I move through the story here.
It's a really nice waterfall down here.
Yeah, there is.
Given those girls love a skinny dipping, I bet they're nearby.
Uh-huh, scrap of fabric.
There's some cloth out here. It looks like it was torn from something.
Strange.
I'll keep looking around.
Yeah. That's a little weird. I don't see the plume of smoke anymore. But it's goddamn... Okay, I gotta take a picture of that. That is too freaking beautiful. Oh my God. The grandeur! Wow, the grand... Oh, can of beer. Found evidence of location.
Found one of their empties. Guess we're on the right track.
Roger
yep.
that.
Roger that. She's gonna watch me beat the shit out of these poor, stupid kids. Teenagers. I don't know. Their age is up in the air. But I'm gonna assume they're 18 and 19 and fully clothed, because it's just getting creepier and creepier every time I try to talk about it. So for my own sake, oh God.
Hey, what's to the south of here?
So pretty.
Mexico? Is this some sort of riddle?
I just have a nice view to the south. You know, trees and mountains forever.
Well, eventually you wander into the area overseen by Chimney Rock Lookout, but that's probably an impossible hike in terms of terrain.
Nothing's impossible when you're a Victoria's Secret model and you got Turt Reynolds on your side.
That's right, Mark! I can do anything!
Wow, that's actually amazing. Like what?
Fly!
Really? And I throw him off the cliffside and he's like,
I was lying!
And then I'm sad and I cry. This is a weird hypothetical situation that I'm getting myself into. Where the hell am I going? Sartha is a smoke. Oh, I'm going backwards. I didn't even know that there was another path over there. I took the wrong turn at the fork in the waterfall there. Sorry, everybody. I'm gonna get back to where I was. I apologize, I'm just too lost in every single scrap of beauty. God, this game is pretty. I mean, there's a lot of different... I've said before, there's a lot of different ways that you can play a game.
Found another.
Roger that.
Uh-huh, that was worth reporting in. Definitely a good use of my time. Glad everyone was here for that one. Wait, no, this isn't right either. Okay. Yeah, that's not right either. Okay, so I gotta cross over the river before the waterfall and then make a right. I'm just getting tossed all over the place because of my stupidity. It's just leading me astray. Here. Oh, I saw the rock out of the corner of my eye. I thought it was blocked off over here. Instead, it was beautiful and probably not going to crush me when I walk under it. Yep, I was right. I'm a genius. All right, where are these? Oh.
I see a campsite, and it looks like they've got a fire.
Is it them?
That seems like it. I swear, they must have dragged 4 cases of beer out here.
Yeah, no joke.
Track them down, and don't let them see you.
What a job this is.
Track them
These
down.
Girls have a full case of beer left here. A full case.
Well, they're impressive little shits, I guess.
That is some dedication.
Dangerous hunks.
Well, I found some dangerous hunks.
What on earth are you...
It's the name of a magazine for girls. Mm-hmm. It's on the ground here at their camp.
Yeah.
I have entered the teen zone.
Oh, really? And where's that?
It's another one of those magazines.
Is this out yet? How many times do I need to stomp that? What are these stupid kids doing with their are they naked again? God, oh no. Oh, that's not good.
Some of their clothes are all torn up.
That's not good.
Not good at all.
You know, maybe I should take one of their sleeping bags as payback.
At this stage, take whatever you want.
What the hell?
Looks like someone left a note.
Intriguing. Maybe you should read it.
Okay, yeah.
Let me know what it says.
Oh. I hope you're fucking happy. We're leaving and we're going to find the police or whatever and tell them about how you creeped on us in the lake and then came and destroyed our campsite and all of our stuff. Oh, and stealing panties is gross out. You're probably a mental fucking axe murderer and are so going to jail. I hope it was worth being a jerk over some fireworks dick. Oh.
Oh, they're gone, for sure.
Well, what's it say?
Threatening to call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well, did you?
No!
No, well, hey, I didn't do this, okay? Someone or something went to town here, but it wasn't me.
Because I told you to scare them, not assault them.
Yeah, I took their whiskey back at the lake, but that just felt like, I don't know, the cost of doing business.
That's different, okay? And I don't blame you.
Mm-hmm.
This is, I don't know, weird as hell, but it wasn't me.
No joke.
It's okay. I believe you. Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know, but they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back, and we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Yeah, me too.
Mm. I have a funny feeling that we're not gonna- Okay, never mind then! It's day 3 now! I had no idea that that's how that was supposed to be. Okay. I guess. Oh, good! Making some progress now. Ta-da! Find some board downstairs. Oh, hey! You thought you could get away from me? Well, you didn't think too strongly about that one, did you? Thanks, Bernie. Your reassurances are always comforting in my heart.
Yeah.
What do you look like?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
Like Burt Reynolds. Yeah, I like this
hard.
One.
I could be Tom Cruise's good-looking twin brother.
Oh, that's too bad. I read in People he's like 5 foot nothing.
Yeah, well, you can't win them all.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
Uh-huh.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
Let's see.
Tuxedos, as often as possible.
Oh, really?
Oh, really?
You bet.
How cosmopolitan. I didn't realize Boulder was so chic.
Mm. It is the peak of high society.
Good to know, yes. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
Ooh. A nose. Thick beard. Nose has been broken. Thin mustache and long scar. Yep, that sounds about right.
Well, I have a thin mustache. Real thin mustache. I got a long scar. Goes down across my eye and down my cheek.
And you only wear tuxes?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Are you a freaking Bond villain?
You got me!
I get up to some stuff, yeah.
You're taking this very seriously.
Oh, no, not at all. Not even a little.
I want to know about your eyes.
My eyes?
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
Your what?
Is that okay?
Yeah, it's fine. Never mind.
Don't answer.
Oh, no.
Do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
Julia. Let's see. Steely, happy, tired. Happy.
They're happy, I think. I mean, I've been told.
I remember the Victoria's Secret, darling. They looked
Julia
very happy.
Julia told you that, huh?
Look, I don't know how to describe eyes.
Happy is good. That's good. Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
Thanks, Delilah.
Get what you need?
Absolutely.
Tux scar, thin mustache. There's gonna be another drawing in my future, but that probably triggered some memories about Julia because Julia liked to draw too. Okay, so anyway, that's where I'm gonna pause this episode. Thank you everybody so much for watching. I'm gonna continue to do this very soon, and then when I get back from my trip to Boston, I'm going to be back into this game until it's done. I actually don't know how long it is, so I'm just gonna keep playing it. So thank you again, and as always, I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye! Our life ruined. We're gonna shoot not each other, but just the ground.
No.
Wait.
No.
Ow!